Sudhamurthy was travelling in Udyan Express and boarded in Gulbarga. Though her second class seat was reserved, there were many unauthorized people in that compartment. Her seat was meant for only two, but six of them were sitting on it and she was pushed to the corner. There were some students, merchants and government officers. The TC came in and started asking for tickets to everyone. The people who didn't have reservations started giving different reasons. But the TC was calm and kept issuing new tickets for ticketless passengers. After checking Sudhamurthy's ticket, he again looked in her direction and asked for a ticket. Sudhamurthy realized quickly that he is asking it to someone who is sitting below her berth. When TC yelled again, a dark 13-year-old, thin, scared, crying girl came out of hiding. Her hair was uncombed, was dressed in torn skirt and blouse. She was trembling and folded her both hands. The TC was very angry at her and was asking her to get down on the next station. People around were busy on their own and no one was bothered about her. When TC started forcibly pulling her out of compartment, Sudhamurthy stopped him and paid for her ticket. The TC advised Sudhamurthy not to help her, saying that the girl might be faking, but Sudhamurthy didn't accept his advice, as she was ready to lose few hundreds, though the TC is true, but she didn't want the girl to get down on the station in the night. The TC insisted Sudhamurthy to pay for the girl's ticket from the train starting point, Bombay to Bangalore. Sudhamurthy made the girl sit on a seat, ordered her food and asked about her background. The girl was hesitant initially and was not ready to eat food. Slowly she started talking. She told Sudhamurthy that her name is Chitra. She lived in a village near Bidar. Her father was a coolie and she had lost her mother at birth. Her father had remarried and had two sons with her stepmother. But a few months ago, her father had died. Her stepmother started beating her often and did not give her food. She was tired of that life. She did not have anybody to support her, so she left home in search of something better. And the train reached Bangalore in the morning. Sudhamurthy got down and said goodbye to Chitra and started walking towards her car. Then Sudhamurthy realized that Chitra was following her. For a moment, she thought that she has put herself in trouble, but she understood that Chitra is clinging to her and she felt safe with her. And Sudhamurthy didn't want to leave her alone in the big city like Bangalore. Sudhamurthy told her to sit in her car and took her to a shelter home supported by Infosys Foundation. Sudhamurthy told Chitra to stay there until she returns from a trip. After 2 weeks, when Sudhamurthy returned to shelter home, she was surprised to see happy Chitra wearing new clothes and teaching lessons to younger kids. The supervisor of the shelter home was praising Chitra and suggested Chitra could go to high school nearby as she is very interested in education. Sudhamurthy sponsored her education. Though Sudhamurthy was very busy, she always inquired her progress either on phone or by visit. Soon, Chitra finished her graduation with flying colors and also got a job in a software company. She bought a sari for Sudhamurthy and some gifts and sweets for everyone in the shelter. She also started paying rent to the shelter home. Days, months, and years passed. Seeing her dedication and hard work, the company sent Chitra to USA. Chitra was in touch with Sudhamurthy through emails and was doing very well in her career. She was posted across several cities in USA and was enjoying life. Years later, Sudhamurthy was invited to deliver a lecture for Kannada organization in San Francisco. After her stay, when Sudhamurthy was checking out from her hotel, the receptionist told her that a lady waiting in a lounge has settled her bill. When Sudhamurthy turned around, she found Chitra there. Chitra was standing with a young white man wearing a beautiful sari, beaming with happiness and pride. She hugged Sudhamurthy and touched her feet. Sudhamurthy was very happy to see her. She asked her about her work, life in USA and about her Mr. Right. Chitra introduced Sudhamurthy to her colleague John and they were getting married soon. Sudhamurthy finally asked her the real question. Why did you pay my bill? You are starting a new life and you should save money for your family. With tears in her eyes and gratitude on her face, Chitra said, Akka, if you hadn't helped me, I don't know where I would have been today. Maybe a beggar, runaway child, servant in someone's house, or maybe not alive. You changed my life. I'm grateful to you. Sudhamurthy responded, No, Chitra, I'm only one step in your ladder. There are many other steps like shelter home, your school, your company, and mainly your dedication and hard work. And again, Sudhamurthy asked, Why did you pay my bill? Chitra did not reply, but told John to touch Sudhamurthy's feet. Then, suddenly sobbing, she hugged Sudhamurthy and said, Because you paid my ticket from Bombay to Bangalore. Friends, this kind act of Sudhamurthy changed Chitra's life forever. What an inspiration she is. We should help needy people in whatever way we can, either by giving food, shelter, clothes, medicines, education, or some guidance. As we don't know how any kind of help can change someone's life forever. And I hope that you enjoyed this story. And I'll come with a new story next Friday. Till then, you please take care. Jai Hind!